Born at Lahore on February 18, 1927, Fazal Mahmood is known as Pakistan's first superstar. He came from an educated and well-respected lineage. His grandfather, Allah Ditta, graduated from King Edward Medical College, was one of the first Muslim doctors in the subcontinent. At the age of 19, Fazal was selected to play for India against Australia in 1947-48, which was going to be his only chance to play against Sir Don Bradman. But amidst mass murder and bloodbath in the region, Fazal had to flee the country in haste. Fazal had already established a reputation, and when British India was being divided, he was offered to play for India. But Fazal chose to stay in Pakistan and opted to play for his country. However, Pakistan was a new nation and lacked systems, finances, and infrastructure. In 1949, the ICC rejected Pakistan's application for test status because of BCCP's failure to submit membership fee. Fazal was worried about his future as a cricketer, but he held his hopes high. However, government of Pakistan was able to allocate some funds and country's test status got restored. In 1949-50, Fazal became a leading bowler on Pakistan's tour of Ceylon. And when Ceylon returned the visit in 1950, he took 20 wickets in two test matches. In 1952, the Pakistani team crossed the border for the test series against India. Their first match was scheduled in Delhi. Before the game, a pretty-looking girl told Fazal, "Good luck, but you can't win against India." Pakistan was defeated by India Delhi. She approached Fazal again and repeated her line. This time, an emotional Fazal replied, "If you want to see India lose, better come to Lucknow." The girl, Indira Gandhi, daughter of then Prime Minister Nehru, and 15 years onwards, she went on to become Prime Minister herself. The match was wrapped up in 4 days as Fazal bagged 20 wickets and Pakistan won by an innings. It was a moment when Fazal left an impression on Indira Gandhi and won hearts back home. Pakistan toured England in 1954 and the team introduced to Queen Elizabeth. During the entire series, England was in a commanding position. But Pakistan somehow managed to draw the matches at Lord's and Old Trafford. During the day 4 at Oval Test, England was at 115 runs for 2 and just needed 53 to win with 8 wickets in hand. Due to the Fazal's brilliant spell, England was restricted to 121 runs for 6 before the day was called off. Pakistan recorded a historic win as last 4 wickets were bottled for 18 runs. The kingdom was fuzzled by Pakistan's magic. Though Fazal missed several games through injury, he finished the tour of 1954 with 77 wickets at 17.53 runs apiece. Fazal took 12 wickets in the game as Pakistan squared the series within a 24-run victory. At home, a national holiday was declared as Pakistan announced their arrival on the cricketing map in style. Today, we mourn, we pay our respects, but most of all, we cherish Fazal Mahmood's contribution to Pakistan.